We are now querying the database through the designer approach. We have generated the ORM models. Now we shall demonstrate how we can perform a query on a database table through the models that have been generated by the ORM designer. In the previous example, we had done the modeling ourselves, we had done the mapping ourselves, and this time the same thing has been done by the ORM. And we also learnt in the last lecture that the first two steps only differ, whereas the remaining step, query and for each, they remain the same. The first two steps about obtaining data, they differ when we obtain data from a collection straightway or when we obtain data from the modeling that has been done by us. And similarly, in this case also, the modeling has been done by the ORM. So these steps will still continue to be the same. The only difference would be how to connect to the data. Once the data is with us, we can use the link queries to query the database and to display the results using the for each in exactly the same manner. The only difference is about these two steps. In our current example, we shall display the entire records of the TBL doctors. We shall display the entire table in our present example, and this is the simplest possible thing that can be done so that you get started. We can have a look at our table TBL doctors. Basically, we have to show the email, the name, and phone of the doctor. We'll display each record using the ORM generated models. So let us see how we can do it. We'll click on the Solution Explorers, add the controllers as usual, add controller, home controller, add, and here, as usual, change it into string and get data and add a private string get data here. And now we have to start writing the code in this block. Open the Solution Explorers. So these are the entity models folder where we added our entities. We had right clicked on this one and gone to add new item, and here we had chosen this one. So this is the folder that is with us. The first step which you should always do is, first of all, add wherever you want to use the ORM classes, you should write at the top the namespace for the folder that contains your entity classes. So I've written using entity. Next now. Now, next thing is you should be aware of the name of your database. Your database name is DB.